to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed the side angle side criterion, that is SAS congruence rule, out of the congruence rule criteria of a triangle. Today we will discuss the next criterion of congruence of triangles, that is angle side angle criterion. In the SAS congruence rule, we have seen that when two sides and the included angle are equal in two triangles, then the triangles are congruent. And the name of this rule itself indicates that the angle that is equal is made by these two sides. Friends, what can you guess from the name of ASA, that is angle side angle congruence rule? Yes, according to this rule, if a triangle's two angles and their included side are equal to another triangle's two angles and their included side, then both triangles are said to be congruent. Let us draw a figure with the help of this statement. Two angles of a triangle MNO, that is angle MNO and angle MON, and their included side, that is side NO, is equal to the two angles of the second triangle PQR, that is angle PQR and angle PRQ and the included side, that is side QR, then both these triangles, that is triangle MNO and triangle PQR, will be congruent. Here we are given that this angle and side are equal, and we have to prove that both these triangles are congruent. If we use the SAS, that is side angle side criterion, for the congruence of both the triangles, then there are three possibilities here. First, if we assume that side MN and side PQ are equal, and we are given that angle MNO and angle PQR are equal, and sides NO and QR are equal, so both these triangles will be congruent according to the SAS congruence rule. But if side MN is greater than side PQ, then we can take point S on side MN such that side SN is equal to side PQ. Now, in triangle SNO and triangle PQR, we created two equal sides SN and PQ. And we are given that angle MNO is equal to angle PQR. That is, angle SNO and angle PQR will be equal, and side NO is equal to side QR. Therefore, according to the SAS congruence rule, we can say that these triangles are congruent. Both the triangles are congruent, so their corresponding parts must be equal. But we are given that angle MON is equal to angle PRQ. This is possible only when point S coincides with point M, or MN equals SN. We formed side SN to be equal to side PQ. From this, we can conclude that it is not possible for side MN to be greater than side PQ. Similarly, if we assume that side MN is smaller than side PQ, then we can take point T on side PQ in such a way that side QT is equal to side MN. Now, again by repeating the same procedure, we can conclude that it is not possible for side MN to be smaller than side PQ. You can try to reach the conclusion by pausing the video. Looking at the three possibilities, we can conclude that here side MN is equal to side PQ. Therefore, according to the SAS congruence criterion, triangle MNO and triangle PQR will be congruent to each other. Thus, by using the side angle side criterion, we prove the angle side angle criterion, that is the ASA congruence rule. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed the angle side angle ASA criterion for the congruence of triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you.